Hey guys, what's up? So I'm here to talk about Sum 41's brand new 6th full-length album, and it's called Screaming Bloody Murder. Now, Sum 41 has literally been one of the bands that, like Rise Against, that I've loved all throughout. I've never been like, I'm over them, you know, they changed their sound, oh, screw them. I've always loved Sum 41. Matter of fact, they're actually probably my favorite pop punk band. It's just something about them, like, I love how, you know, they're pop punk, but with like kind of like a darker, heavy sound, and with a lot of great guitar work, and it's just a great live band. It's just something about them that I love, and maybe they're from Canada, and I love Canada. I don't know, but I've always loved this band. A lot of people, and I guess you can kind of include me in this, were a little bit disappointed with their last album, Underclass Hero. It had a bit of a different sound for them. They were kind of progressing, you know. They kind of started off as like a typical pop-punk band, and then as the albums went on, they kind of adopted more of a heavier, kind of like metal-influenced pop-punk sound. And they kept progressing, and then with their last album, they kind of went back with kind of like a pop-punk, Green Day-ish type of album. And while it wasn't bad, and I do enjoy that album, it's by far my least favorite album by them. And a lot of people were wanting, you know, their next full length to kind of go back to the Chuck sound. And that's the thing. A lot of people find Chuck to be their favorite album. Me, I'm kind of in the middle. I kind of love Does This Look Infected, and I kind of love Chuck, and I love actually both of them. If I can get an album and kind of combine both of them, that would be my perfect album. But this album, I can happily kind of say that it does kind of resemble Chuck. To me, what I see, it's kind of like a Chuck, Sum 41 Chuck album meets Green Day's American Idiot, with a little My Chemical Romance's Black Parade kind of all formed into one, which in my opinion is a much better album than Underclass Hero. So, and the album cover, which I don't really like at all, here you go. It's kind of like a murder scene type of CSI crime unit type of album cover, which is okay. I mean, it's just an album cover, but it's by far my least favorite. There's 14 tracks, and it's kind of like in the vein of their last album in like the song lengths. There's kind of it's kind of mixture. You kind of have from the shortest 2 minutes and 50 seconds to 4 minutes and 48 seconds. So it's kind of mixed in there. I'm going to go through this tracks hopefully fast. First song is called Reason to Believe. It's kind of like a intro, kind of starts off with some little drums, and it kind of builds up to like this kind of heavy midsection, and then it kind of goes slower a little bit at the end. Pretty cool intro, not the best. I was hoping kind of for like a shorter intro. Next is Screaming Bloody Murder. Amazing song. It's the title track of the album. Kind of like a heavy, you know, guitar, awesome guitar work, Chuck-influenced song, sorry. Very good, amazing guitar work, awesome chorus, awesome verses, awesome. Next song is Scumfuck. It's a shorter song. The original demo was like a shorter song, but then they kind of added like this little intro, like singing intro, which is also quite different for this album. There's a less of that kind of like rap singing that he kind of used to do, and it's more like actual kind of singing. You know, there's his little like kind of like grunt punk voice that he kind of does, but then there's a lot of singing as well. Not too many of that rap stuff, which is pretty cool. You know, nothing horrible. But Scumfuck is kind of like a fast kind of like punk rock, old school keyboard punk rock sounding song. Very cool. Next is Time for You to Go, which is kind of sounds like My Chemical Romance, like Black Parade, Green Day's 21st Century type of sound. It's different, but I like it. You know, it's not my favorite, but it's got a cool like rock and roll sound to it, which is, you know, it's kind of like a toe tapper. It's good. Next up is by far my favorite song on the album. It's called Jessica Kill. It's the shortest song. It is like a heavy Chuck sounding song. It kind of reminds me of Angels with Dirty Faces. Very heavy, so good, amazing guitar work, awesome heavy like chorus, like angry song. Great. Next up is What Am I to Say, which is one of two slower songs. It kind of reminds me of With Me and Best With Me from Underclass Hero, that kind of slow sound. You know, it's like, it has full instrumentation, but it's like a slower, like, song. You'll know what I'm talking about when you hear it. Next up, actually track 7, 8, and 9, which is called Holy Image of Lies, track 7, Sick of Everyone, track 8, and Happiness Machine, track 9. It's kind of like, it's three songs, but it's kind of like a continuation, kind of like a Jesus of Suburbia, but not, you know, spread into different, or not one track, it's just kind of split into different parts. I would have liked it better if it was just one long song, because when you kind of just listen to one individually, it doesn't kind of sound right. You know, you kind of have to listen to all three going together. But I really like it a lot. You know, it's they do so many different things throughout these three tracks. It's so, like, it's heavy, but there's a lot of, like, signature time changes, like, different vocally stuff going on in there. It's very different, very unique, very good. That's what I love. You know, it sounds like them, but it's different, and they're doing a lot, like, different things that you haven't heard from them, especially throughout those three tracks. Very good, very different. Definitely check it out. I don't know which parts I like best out of the three. I kind of like Holy Image of Lies, track 7, and track 8 a little bit more than track 9, but track 10 is called Crash. It's the slowest song. Very piano driven song. I don't think there's any drums or bass, but it's okay. It's probably my least favorite song. I mean, it's very pretty sounding, but, you know, I could have done without that song. Next up is Blood in My Eyes. It's kind of like a heavy, mid-tempo, Chuck sounding song. It's very good. You know, it's got great guitar work. It's kind of like mid-tempo throughout. Then all of a sudden, there's kind of like this little heavy breakdown at the end. Not really breakdown, but like this kind of crazy guitar stuff going on at the end. It's really, really good. Next up is Baby You Don't Want to Know. And it kind of is familiar. Kind of sounds like Time For You to Go, track 4. Kind of has that My Chemical Romance, Green Day rock and roll type of sound. Very good, too. Both of them kind of have like this very easy, accessible, kind of catchy sing-along type of vibe to both of them. Very good. Next up is the real last song. It's called Back Where I Belong. Awesome way to end the album for the most part. I mean, it's not really the last song, but it kind of reminds me of There's No Solution from Chuck. It's a very good song. Kind of mid-tempo but heavy Chuck sounding. Once again, you'll know what I'm talking about. And finally, the last song is called Exit Song. It's kind of like an outro, not much going on, but it's cool, atmospheric type of sounding song. But and this is not really part of the album, but I want to mention this song. It's called We're the Same. It's a bonus track. I don't know if it's going to be for iTunes or Best Buy. I don't know yet, but this song is amazing. It's got kind of like a faster, almost Does This Look Infected type of... It's kind of like Does This Look Infected meets Chuck type of sounding song, which is awesome. And I'm perplexed as to why this is not on the album. I kind of hate when bands do that, when they kind of throw in an incredibly awesome song that could have been on the album as like a bonus. I just hate that. But it's so good. Anyways, there you have it. It's not my favorite Sum 41 album, for sure. It's up there. It's my favorites is probably Does This Look Infected, Chuck, and then Screaming Bloody Murder, and then All Killer, Half Hour Power, and then Underclass Hero. But this is an amazing step forward, you know? It's not a perfect album. There's a few songs I could do without. You know, I could do without Crash, and maybe one of the songs out of that little trilogy section middle of the album. Maybe, like, I could have done without Happiness Machine. But for the most part, I really dig this album. I've listened to this a lot. I've probably listened to this album a good six, seven times, and it just keeps getting better and better. I'm going to give this a 4.5. I'm really impressed with this album. It's great step in the right direction, and I'm really excited for the next one, because I feel like they're kind of going more towards the Chuck side, which is what all of us want. So that's great. My favorite songs are Jessica Kill by far, Screaming Bloody Murder, and probably Back Where I Belong. So thanks guys for watching. Definitely pick up this album. It's amazing. Thanks guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.